August 26, 2021. Guys, you're looking at the latest from the National Hurricane Center. Tropical Depression 9 has formed. It is moving at 35 miles an hour. Sustained winds, minimum pressure 1,005, and it's moving northwest at 13 miles an hour. That's going to, again, put it across that tip of Cuba. When we look at the information here, we got at 11 a.m. Thursday. Once it comes across Cuba, that which would be at 8 p.m. Friday, it's going to be strengthening quickly, moving ashore sometimes between Sunday and Monday. Again, South Mississippi, Louisiana, you're in the gun. The left side of this particular path has it scraping Texas, but the models are centered now on South Louisiana. This is what it looks like this morning. The Caribbean satellite images, south of Cuba. Check that out. It's going to, again, move northwest, 13 miles an hour right now. So you don't have a whole lot of time. The weekend's coming up, and that's going to be over with, and the storm's going to be on the same satellite, but infrared images here. The area where the storms are, guys, over Jamaica, is not the complete center or the complete circulation of it. But notice by Sunday at 8 a.m., 110 mile per hour category 2 hurricane. It's not going to take much more than that, guys, to go to a category 3. Not much at all. You're coming ashore, but again, between that Sunday at 8 a.m. and Monday at 8 a.m., it will be a Cat 1 ashore in Louisiana, very close to the Mississippi-Louisiana corner. All the models, again, are pointing a dead hit on Louisiana, except for two pulling it over toward that East Mississippi coastline next to Alabama. Here comes our first storm. This is a Canadian model, one of the two we always watch, right up the Mississippi River here. It's followed by a second Caribbean storm and a third storm that's out into the Atlantic. We don't know much about these yet, except that they're predicted to happen. This is the one we got to pay attention to right there. Check that out. Also, we'll look at the Navy model. We compare these two. It's showing the same track as a Canadian model now. When they do this, you're pretty close to exactly where this thing's going to go. And this is going to throw a lot of rain at that track into New Orleans area, a lot of water. Now, I've been watching the sun also, and we've had a couple explosions. You're looking at a CME that's going to gaze our planet here sometimes into today or tomorrow. It's a side glancing blow. It's what they're calling it. But it was a very powerful solar eruption. We'll take a look at it. Notice your timestamp. 24th, double explosions. One on the left, one on the right, followed by another one on the right. And so we're kicking back up into this solar activity. Now, this is an amazing explosion you're about to see. Check this out. Again, timestamps at the bottom. Here's where we had a partial eclipse due to the location of the satellite in our planet. But check that out. On the left side, what you just saw was an extremely large filament release. We're going to let it play back through. Watch this left side of this image. That is the CME that they're saying is going to scrape our planet here in the next couple of days. Depends on the speed or what I call the muzzle velocity as it leaves the sun. Watch this. There's your clip in the left side right there, guys. And you can see it. It was a left side explosion, and that's why the CME tracker is tracking it there. But I just want to kind of put a watch up for some earthquakes over the next 2 days because of that particular filament. Again, we'll watch the northern ring of fire. Guys, again, excuse the mic. We're traveling and trying to get up the best information I can at this point. We're watching it. You watch it. It's a heads up. Be safe. I will stay on top of this regardless of the situation here until the storm comes ashore. Heads up. Be safe.